So let's begin. So the next paper presentation is going to be by Prabash. I hope you're here. Yeah. And it's going to be on unsupervised joint multitask learning of vision geometry tasks. Please go ahead.
Thank you. I will share my screen now. I hope my screen is visible. Okay. Yes. Okay, good afternoon, everyone. I am Prabhash Kumar Jha. I will be presenting our work title, Unsupervised Joint Multitask Learning of Vision Geometry Tasks. I did this work together with Deutschen Sanev and Luka Lukic. This talk is mainly divided into six subsections. In the first section, we will see what motivated us for this work. And the next section, we'll see why we went ahead with unsupervised learning approach. And in third section, we'll see our approach in details. And then we will evaluate our approach. And then we will see some ablation study to justify our method. And in the end, we'll conclude the presentation. Okay. Some of the most important computer vision tasks are estimating the depth of each pixel in a scene taken from a monocular camera, which is also known as monocular depth estimation. Another very important task is given two temporal images taken from a camera to estimate how the camera would have moved between two temporal images in three dimensions. There are three translation components, three rotation components, which is also known as camera pose estimation. Another very important task is to know where each pixel has moved given two temporal images, which is also known as optical flow estimation. So here we can see in the optical flow diagram, the color of optical flow shows the direction of movement of pixel and the intensity shows the magnitude of movement. Last but not the least, one of the most important vision tasks is to know, given the two temporal images, whether each pixel in the scene has moved or remained static in three dimensions. Optical flow gives us a measurement in two dimensions and rigidity mask we get in three dimensions. That's the difference. So most of the current approaches related to multitask learning use a technique known as no parameter sharing approach, which is also known as soft parameter sharing. So in this approach, they use individual task-specific networks, and these networks learn together by combining their output in geometrical fashion. Another category of work, which is slightly less common, is to use hard parameter sharing approach. In this approach, we have a common encoder for all the tasks, and then we have task-specific heads for each task. And most of the work which we reviewed use semi-supervised learning to achieve this goal. Since most of the work use individual networks to solve these four vision tasks, we decided to come up with a network which will learn all of the tasks jointly using unified network. So the obvious benefit of this approach would be it would save computation, and we can learn features which are generic to all the tasks. And we propose to use completely unsupervised learning to learn all the tasks. So one question might come immediately, that why are we going with unsupervised learning? So to explain that, as we know that getting annotated real world training or testing data is hard and expensive. Although we have some hardware available to measure some of the tasks, like to get depth estimate, we have LiDAR sensors, but we know that the estimate is quite sparse. For some of the computer vision tasks, like optical flow, we don't have any available device which can measure that. Although it can be measured by fitting in accurate CAD models in laboratory, but that's quite tedious. One might argue that instead of going with real data, we can use synthetic data to train our tasks. But we know that there exists a domain gap between synthetic data and real data. Last but not the least, given that these computer vision tasks are geometrically related, one can exploit the geometrical relationship between them to create loss terms. In this section, we will see the approach that we used in our work. For all our training, we use Kitty dataset. And this is our proposed network for jointly learning all the tasks. We used modified ResNet 50 based network as our base network. And we modified it in such a way that it can take 5 input images so that we can provide those features for other task heads as well. Okay, and this base network measures the depth estimation. And when it comes to the individual task heads, we can see that optical flow and rigidity mask task heads have convolutional blocks. And when it comes to pose prediction, it has a residual block, and the end it has a spatial average pooling layer. Okay. So for training all these tasks, we use commonly available unsupervised losses. The first loss, which jointly trains depth and pose network, is photometric reconstruction loss. Also, we can train the flow network by using the predicted flow, by warping the current image using the predicted flow to the next image to construct photometric reconstruction loss as well. And since rigidity mask is quietly something related to segmentation task, so we can use cross entropy loss for that. And we can use consensus loss to link the learning for all the tasks. And in the end, to regularize our training, we can use smoothness prior. Okay. Although these 4 tasks are geometrically related, but the quantities that they're searching in an image is widely different. That's why when we simply attach all the task head and try to train them together using the loss functions, the training does not converge. So we propose to introduce the task head one at a time. In a fashion, we propose as 2-stage learning, so that once we attach a task head to our existing network, we freeze the parameters present in the existing network, and we let the task head to learn on the frozen parameters. So once this task head has learned some features, we unfreeze the network, and we let the entire network learn together. We call this as dual stage learning. Now we will evaluate our network. To have a fair evaluation of our network, we train all of the tasks using no parameter sharing approach. And this result acted as our baseline. And in using hard parameter sharing approach, we train these networks using the same losses. As we can see on the left side, we have the result from hard parameter sharing approach. On the right side, we have the result from no parameter sharing approach. And we see that the results using hard parameter sharing approach is quite comparable to what we get from no parameter sharing approach. Now coming to numerical evaluation, we see that using hard parameter sharing approach, which is also, we also call it ARS, it's quite comparable with no parameter sharing approach. At the same time, we save a quarter of parameters. Now we will show some ablation study which will justify our design decision. Since we propose that instead of learning a new task head directly after attaching it, we should learn it in a 2-stage fashion. So the obvious advantage of this is that the performance of base task, which is a depth estimate, is preserved when we do dual stage learning as compared to single stage learning, as we see in this diagram. Also, for pose estimate, we get better performance when we use this approach. And for flow and mask, we get almost same result. And this approach also does not change any parameter count. It's just the fashion in which we train the networks. In another experiment we did was to see whether we should have residual blocks in post task head or simply simple convolution blocks. So what we did was to replace the convolutional layer in the post task head with a residual block and see how it performs when we train it. We found that using residual block in pose task head improved the performance of almost all our tasks. At the same time, there was slightly increase in parameter count of the network. So now we will conclude our presentation. So we showed that it is possible to encode the features of this geometrically related task into a common encoder using fully unsupervised learning. We also demonstrated that if we use dual stage learning, so the performance of base task, that is depth estimation, improves. Also, using residual block in pose task head improves the performance of joint network overall. Thanks for your attention.
Thank you, Prabash. So let's open up for a few questions. Does anyone have a question? So I had a short question myself. So you described the rigidity task and you said it's related with the semantic segmentation task. Could you define a bit more what exactly rigidity is and how it is correlated with the semantic segmentation task?
Okay. Rigidity mask is not related to semantic segmentation. Rigidity mask is like if a pixel is moving in real world or not. If a pixel is moving in three dimension, we call it non-rigid. If pixel is static, it's rigid. But we use similar laws, which is used in semantic segmentation.
Oh, yeah, I see.
Understood. Thank you.
Thank you. Any questions further from the audience? Let's see. Any?
Okay. If there are no further questions, then thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much, Prabash.
Thank you.
So,